From deep in the heart of Texas, ESPN's Bowl Week rolls on down the river. Tonight from San Antonio, it's the fourth-ranked Kansas State Wildcats and the Purdue Boilermakers at the Builder Square Alamo Bowl. Remember the Alamo. The players and fans of Kansas State certainly will, after they turned in the storybook season of their lives. One final slip-up at just the wrong time left the Wildcats out of the bowl championship series and searching for answers why. The Alamo gladly offered them a place to call their holiday home. Tonight, a dream matchup of quarterbacks from Kansas State senior Michael Bishop, the electrifying Heisman Trophy runner-up. And from Purdue, sophomore Drew Brees, the Big Ten Offensive Player of the Year. The Purdue fans may have outshouted the Wildcats at Sunday's pep rally, but the town has been painted purple ever since. The best traveling fans in college football have made themselves at home in San Antonio, as more than 25,000 K-State faithful have come from all points of Kansas to the Builder Square Alamo Bowl. It's the Big 12 versus the Big 10. Kansas State taking on Purdue here at the Alamo Dome. Hi, everybody. Ron Franklin, welcome to San Antonio, Texas. And first of all, let me say from all of us to all of you, we hope that you and your family are having a simply great holiday season. Both the quarterbacks tonight from the state of Texas coming back home, so to speak. Willis, Texas for Bishop, and Austin Westlake High School for Drew Brees. Brees, to me, can present as many or more problems as K-State has had defensively this year, Mike.
36 touchdown passes, Ron. He's a very accurate passer. They have a possession offense. He'll throw the ball deep. He's got a good arm. He'll scramble. Bill Snyder said he'll frustrate you when you try to put the rush on him because he'll take off and gain some yardage. And the problem you were talking about, Ron, is they'll bring in three wide receivers, sometimes four wide receivers. The best three players on defense for Kansas State are their linebackers, but they may be forced to be on the sideline by the formation. So it's going to be a chess match by Mike Stoops and the defensive coordinator and Jim Chaney, the Purdue offensive coordinator, formations and how they defend them.
We'll keep up with that, Mike, and I think it will be fun to watch. Joe Tiller, second season at Purdue, coming there from the Western Athletic Conference from Wyoming, has been very, very successful. And this man here, 10 seasons at K-State, the Bear Bryant National Coach of the Year, Bill Snyder, 77 victories, 38 losses, and one tie. And interesting in visiting with him 2 days ago, and I posed the question to him, are you at the mental state you would like with your ball club? And he said, I would have to say no. You would always like a little bit more. But he said, I think they'll be ready to play because we give them 48 hours. They had that workout on Sunday, and then they let them get their legs back. Nothing but pictures yesterday.
You'll know, Ron, as the game goes along, because if they lack concentration, it'll show up in penalties and mistakes as we go through this ball game.
Martin Gramatica, you see his numbers. That's incredible. 96 kickoffs and 51 of those touchbacks. Number two, this is Clopton and Randall Lane, the two deep men for the Purdue Boilermakers. K-State won the toss. They deferred, and this one is underway. Gets by Clopton and goes into the end zone. And so the Boilermakers will scrimmage from their 20-yard line. And let's check in on the sideline with Adrian Karsten. Adrian.
Ron, thanks very much. Now, moments ago, you and Mike mentioned Michael Bishop. What I've heard out of this quarterback and his teammates over the past half hour, I can tell you at least the Wildcats look and sound like they're ready to play this game. Now, sometimes the way a team warms up, what they have to say, and then the way they play can be very different things. But I saw the big offensive lineman, Ryan Young, get his group together and say, look, you guys, you take the 3 weeks of frustration and disappointment and anger and let it go. Just let it go. We're in the national spotlight. We have a lot to prove to the college football world. And, Ron, it's that kind of solidarity that has Joe Diller concerned.
Well, I think he would have to be. First play from scrimmage. Brees sets up at a shotgun. They fake the run. Brees to throw, and he is low and away. Gabe Cox, the intended receiver. Offensively, this is the way they begin. Brees, and he'll have only one running back, Jay Crabtree. They'll have as many as four wide receivers, but they started out this way. Randolph at tight end, Jones, Cox, and Randall Lane, the receivers. And the offensive line, it's a good group. Matt Light is the best of the offensive line. Niedrick right there in the middle. Jim Niedrick is the man who will call the defensive sets. Second down and 10. Puts touch on this one, and the ball is dropped by Isaac Jones. Right in the hands. Coverage was good, but he was there. The pass was there, and all of a sudden, just what Joe Tiller didn't want. Third down and long as you take a look at the defense. Joe Bob Clements, Roe McIntosh, and Darren Howard, the defensive front. Maybe the best group of linebackers in America. Oaks, Kelly, and Simino. And in the secondary, it is Butler, Carter, Lamar, Chapman, and Cooper, the strong safety.
Ron, we talked about this. All three of those linebackers are off the field right now.
Brees under pressure. Gets it away. Has it complete, and that is Chris Daniels for the first down. You could see that Brees bought himself extra time with his mobility. Good for 13 yards, and it was Chapman who was coming after it.
And that's what Bill Snyder was talking about. He frustrates defensive linemen and secondary that brought both safeties on a blitz, Proctor and Lamar Chapman, but he bought some time and got the ball out to Chris Daniels. But all three of the key linebackers for Kansas State were on the sideline.
Crabtree, again, the lone setback as Brees goes under center. Gonna have to hurry. Those linebackers pinch in. Gets it away. Got it complete at the 39-yard line. What a stick. Semino comes up to make the hit on Chris Daniels, but it's still a gain by Purdue. Going to call it about 6 yards in the play.
And this is exactly what Joe Tiller and Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, want. They want Drew Brees to start off, have some success here early with some good key throws.
Daniels comes off the field for a moment after that stick by Semino. Try to get the cobwebs free of him. 2 of 4, 19 yards. Drew Brees. They go with a running play. Not much there as Crabtree spins around. Maybe a gain of 1, but I don't believe so. Where the linesman has come in, and again, they're going to play with a third down and more than 5 yards to get the first.
Yeah, and Drew Brees has had an excellent year, 336 of 516 pass attempts, 36 touchdowns, 3,753 yards in kind of the changing of the guard in the Big Ten Conference.
Well, a lot of people told Joe that he couldn't come in there and play this kind of offense. No backs, four wide receivers, but they've made it work. And here we go, empty backfield. Just Brees. Steps up, got it incomplete, and a close to pass interference on Chapman. No flag on the play, and it'll be punting time. And you hear the booing from the Purdue partisans, and I'm not sure that I disagree with them. It looked as though Chapman was over his back as the ball got there.
They shifted Isaac Jones out of the backfield, got him lined up on Lamar Chapman, a safety, and you can see the contact.
So Chapman got by with one. Now the punting situation, and this is dangerous anytime it happens, because punt returns and kick returns of all kinds, as it is blocked by K-State. Picked up by the Wildcats, and inside the 15-yard line is McGraw, and there was a flag down at the sideline.
Now, Ron, I like the strategy by Bill Snyder, because you want your ball club in this thing.
Offside, Kansas State.
But I like the idea of forcing the action. They did it on defense, a lot of man coverage. They do it on the first punt by going after it. And he's trying to stir his football team up right now.
Claiborne is a man who came through and got it.
Yeah, Chris Claiborne came through and was not touched.
Now, you plant that seed in the punter's mind. It doesn't matter if this is coming back. But the point is, the kick returners by Kansas State are as good as anybody in the nation. Now, interestingly enough, Chapman is the man who was back that time. But David Allen is the nation's leader, and he's being punished. He's not returning kicks tonight because of some kind of violation during this week. We're not told what.
Ron, the key thing on this is it's a first down for Purdue. The five-yard penalty, so a mistake by Kansas State. Still like the pressure. They don't like the offsides, but it gives Drew Brees a chance to get back on the field.
So Bill Snyder paces the sideline and says, well, I thought they had more than five to pick up the first, but well, obviously they didn't.
I think that's what he's asking, but they measured it first down Purdue.
So the Boilers come back to the line of scrimmage. Niedrick over the football, a junior out of LaGrange, Georgia. And it's a quick screen out in the flat, and look at the quickness of the defense. Isaac Jones makes the catch, and Cooper comes up pell-mell and knocks him down for a loss.
Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator right here, is going to take the Oklahoma defensive coordinator job as soon as this football game's over. I talked to him before the ball game. He says, I'm never going into a game with 5 pages of game plans. He said, but Purdue has forced me. And he said, I hope I don't get to them.
Kelly goes out. Rowe goes out. So that means that only two of the linebackers are in. As you look at Venables, he is also part of that defensive coordinator positioning. And look at the run by Brees. Going to take it up to the 50-yard line. Seminole really put a lick on him. But Drew is going to have a gain of 11 yards.
Ron, when you get into a passing situation and all of a sudden you play two linebackers, here's the linebacker and Drew Brees is going to run the quarterback draw because you get good blocking by David Cohen. When you play with six in the box, it opens up the run, and Drew Brees takes advantage of it.
After the hit that he took then from Oaks and Seminole, he may give that a little more serious thought before he does it again. Like, you see the numbers, and they're incredible. Big Ten passing records galore this year, and keep in mind, he's only a sophomore. Pass knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Pick number 77, Damian McIntosh. He's the man who got up and knocked it down.
Well, we've talked about the fact of would Kansas State play. And then you can say right now, their defense has come to play.
So, here's the situation. Rodgers is back to punt. Chapman again is the deep man. And they got to it a moment ago. Lamar Chapman. Junior out of Liberal, Kansas, is the deep man. As we mentioned, normally David Allen would be back there, the speedster from Liberty, Missouri, but he is not doing it here in the early part of the ballgame. Don't know if he's going to be punished for the entire game or not. As his punt is going to hit at the one and go into the end zone. And Joe Tiller sighs a huge sigh of relief following a 50-yard punt. So there's a break in the action. No score as K-State is coming to bat.
With Kansas State and Purdue still scoreless, K-State turned the ball over in their own territory to end the first quarter. We pick up the action at the start of the second quarter, where Purdue has the ball on the Kansas State 21, first down and 10, here on ESPN Classic.
Well, there's no score. And if somebody had told us this was going to be a defensive struggle, we probably would have argued with them, Mike Godfrey.
Yeah, they had all the makings, and still does, of some points being put on this board. Stats after first quarter, and when you look at Purdue, only 39 passing yards, and Kansas State, nothing in the air. The two turnovers big.
How about this? Time of possession, 4:57 K-State, 10:03 for the Boilermakers. Wow. Brees blitz coming right up the middle. They roll the pocket. Can he get it away? Yes, got a man open. His tight end at Stratton. And he steps out of bounds at the 10-yard line. It'll be first and goal, Purdue. Seminole was really coming all after it.
Ron, here's what opens the passing game. Well, because Kansas State is stopping the passing game, they only have five people. When you look at one linebacker and four to the empty set, Drew Brees takes advantage of that because he runs the draw for a big first down. Now, that'll help open the passing game. Even though Drew Brees has taken a lick on that, that is a big play for them.
First and goal. Again, empty backfield. Nobody behind Brees. He takes it from under center. Drills it, and it should have been caught. And that's two passes tonight that Jones has had hit him right in the hands, and he dropped.
Now, Mike Stoops has told his defensive players they're going to get yards. But when they get inside the 20-yard line, we've got to play great red zone defense here. Isaac Jones, number six, getting away from the defender. Looks like Milton Proctor just couldn't hold on to the football.
A little bit slow to react. He only came up with one hand.
Ron, here's another offside penalty against Kansas State. So that's going to benefit Purdue again as the ball's moved to the 5-yard line.
So first down and goal now from 5 yards away, 6 of 17 for Brees.
Now when can you think of 3 offside penalties in a quarter and about 8 seconds?
Now they're moving into the K-State end of the field. That's a reason Brees is having to come up. Blitz right up the middle. Looking, delivers, touchdown, and he's got Chris Daniels.
And then just bumps off of Keith Black and then comes back and runs a curl.
Extra point attempt. That's Travis Dorich. And he knocks it home. As on the sideline, Keith Black talks with his head coach. It is all of a sudden Purdue 7 and Kansas State nothing. And the heavy underdogs in this ball game have jumped up and bitten them. The heavy favorites. So let's take a timeout. You take one more look at Daniels with the touchdown reception. Back in the excitement in the Alamo Dome is on the side of Purdue. They lead it 7-0. And the interesting question is, will Bunton kick it away to either Allen or number 3, Frank Murphy, who are back deep? As folks, Murphy fumbled a moment ago, but Murphy is a 4-2-2 sprinter. He's the fastest man on a K-State team, and he gets it 5 yards deep. And his teammates say, nope, let's don't try to return this one.
Ron, here's what Chris Daniels is going to do to Keith Black. He's going to run like a fade, and then he's going to curl. He plays the fade all the way. Keith Black, number 2, thinks it's going to be a fade, so he gets on the hip. Now he's looking for the football. He just kind of lost concentration, a little push off, and curl route for the touchdown for Chris Daniels. A happy Drew Brees. And Mike Stoops, defensive coordinator, a little frustrated in the press box.
So Kansas State will go from their own 20-yard line and now trailing by a touchdown, 7-0. Pressure from the backside, and he is going to be sacked again by Colvin. Ball came loose, but the officials say no, he was down at the 10-yard line.
Rosevelt,
they say down, but it is Purdue's football, Mike. They have awarded it. They have awarded it to Purdue.
Well, Rosevelt Colvin came off the corner. He's from Broad Ripple High School in Indianapolis. Then compared to former Purdue and 49er Keena Turner from the outside. Michael Bishop arguing the point, but number 59, Rosevelt Colvin, they're blocking him with 2 players. That's Justin Swift, the tight end, stayed in on him.
And that's a great call. You can see the ball coming out. Watch it right here. It is coming out there. He clearly
took it out.
He took it away from him. And in fact, if his knee had not been down, he would have been allowed to take it into the end zone for the touchdown. So right now, Purdue going to have to hurry to get this play on.
3 turnovers again. Drew Brees is going to take a timeout.
Yeah, they call the timeout. Otherwise, the clock was down to 2 seconds as they came sprinting on the field. K-State was sprinting on as well. So McIntosh for K-State. And that gentleman, Rosevelt Colvin, having outstanding defensive nights for their respective football teams.
And again, Kansas State just can't get started. Ron, they 3 turnovers now, numerous penalties, offside penalties. They just look like a team that lacks concentration. On the other side, you got Drew Brees. You talked about their lack of time get the playoff. He came right out on the field and called timeout. And interesting story. Danny Hope, the other day, the offensive line coach on Monday night, was doing bid check, and at 11 o'clock, he couldn't find Drew Brees. So he went down to where the coaches have an office in the hotel, and at midnight, he found Drew Brees. He was watching tape, so an alert player.
Check in on the sideline with Adrian Karsten. Adrian?
Right, I just breezed in from Austin, Texas to watch number 15. And believe me, I am not the only one wearing this button. 150 friends of Drew's parents are here from Austin tonight. They came up with that many tickets, plus another, I think it was 65, Ron, from friends and teammates to make 215 people. They're all here tonight along with other people from West Lafayette, Indiana. Everyone talks about the Kansas State contingent, 25,000 people. Ron, you're a gentleman. I know you understand, but you're not the favorite son from Austin here tonight.
A long way from it. A long way from it, Adrian. Well, what an opportunity for the Boilermakers. First down just outside the 10-yard line. Brees drills it. Incomplete. That was Isaac Jones, the man he was looking for. Chapman with the cover that time.
And talking about Drew Brees, Ron, you know, the fact that when Kansas State, you talked about it earlier, became the opponent for Purdue, I think it really helped Purdue because they were coming back the Alamo Bowl again. And Drew Brees said it best, we'll find out how good we are against a good Kansas State football team.
Well, I'm going to tell you something, Mike. I don't know why, if he's having trouble in these lights or what, but that's three footballs that Jones has had hit him right in the hands tonight.
Well, he hadn't missed many during the year, 72 receptions.
Quarterback draw, and Brees spins off at the 2-yard line, make it the 3. And it will be a third down and goal as McGraw finally got it.
And that's the complimentary run that Purdue has to kind of get in a situation where you see again four defensive linemen. Here's a safety. So the middle is wide open for Drew Brees when he has no backs in the backfield. And you can see how it opens. He picks up 5, 6, 7 yards until the tackle was finally made by John McGraw.
Third down and 2 for the Boilermakers. Gonna have to hurry. 1 second, they just got it off. Brees' pass and dropped this time by Daniels.
Ron, I'm not sure they got it off in time. No, they didn't.
Nope, you're right.
Which is a break for Purdue.
Cross to the snap. We have to lay a game on the offense. 5 yards.
And they'll get that third down back.
It is amazing how many passes have been dropped by the Purdue receivers tonight. Now, I have to admit, he doesn't look quite as sharp yet as he has during the season, but those are catchable football.
Ron, passing teams again. Early start, Chris Daniels, number 20, with an out route.
Oh, you got
a little bit behind
that.
Him. He's got to catch that football. But a break, because the delay of game gives another opportunity to Drew Brees to get in the end zone.
That's 4 drops we have unofficially up here of passes that should have been caught. Of course, that one will not go in the books that way because of the penalty. Third down and 7. Pumps it. Now delivers and knocked away and incomplete. Trying to go to Randall Lane. Boy, he had some heat on that one.
Yep. Almost too close to put the zip on that he did, but it looked like Randall Lane had a chance to catch that football. You know, you go back to the delay of game penalty and you wonder at this part of the season, but there's so many checkoffs at the line of scrimmage. You take so much time and look for matchups that sometimes you get caught on delay of games.
Travis Dortch, 13 of 19 this year. It's a 25-yard attempt. They get it down, and the kick, he squeezes it in on that left side. Let's take a break. If you just joined us, a little surprised? Well, I think everybody is. 10 to nothing, Boilermakers over K-State. Welcome back to San Antonio. It's 10 to nothing, and the folks wearing the colors of Purdue are the ones who are standing and cheering right now. You're looking at Michael Bishop on the sideline. Here comes the kick. Last one by Bunton was in the end zone. This one is returnable, and this is Murphy at the goal line. He is a 4-2-2 sprinter. And he ran into his own blocker and is going to be stopped just short of the 30-yard line. That was Bell who made the tackle, 28 yards on the return. Injured Purdue player at the 28-yard line. Doug Withers is the man who is down and being attended to by the training staff of the Boilermakers.
Ron, Michael Bishop needs to get things started for his Kansas State offense. Been a little slow starting. You go back to, you talked about how he was at the banquet, but he's had pressure on him. Chike O'Keefer makes the first sack on him. Then the interception, Billy Gustin. And then the hit by Rosevelt, Colvin coming around the corner and stealing the football away from him. But he's a big play quarterback. He can do it with his arm, and he can do it running the football. He can change this game right back around.
I thought on the last series of the first quarter, when they ran the speed option back into this side of the field just before the fumble, that they looked as though they were getting a little bit more in sync, but then they turned it over. Bishop going to take the ball for maybe a gain of one. Mitrion is there to make the tackle and then helps him up. Adrian Karsten, what do you have for us?
Ron, remember right after the opening kickoff, I told you that it looked and sounded like Kansas State was ready to play football. Well, there is a difference, as you've been pointing out, between intensity and focus. These guys, offensively and defensively, have been getting an earful because they haven't been playing under control, not running proper routes, not listening to the snap count, not getting into position offensively and defensively. That's where they're short.
Short drop. It's a quarterback draw. This is a design play as he'll take it out of the 35. You could see he was right behind that big guard that they pulled.
Yeah, and you can see now, right now, that Bill Snyder is going to try to get Michael Bishop involved in this football game as a running back. He gained 899 yards rushing during the season, carried 23 times versus Texas A&M. So he's a hard-nosed, tough quarterback that not only throws the football, but will run it up inside.
Well, that's his longest run of the night. It's a gain of eight. Here comes the pressure from the outside, and they throw the screen. Hickson, and that is a nice recovery defensively. Mitrion is there, and also Felge. You could see him coming over the top, and I'm not sure he got the first down.
No, he's short. Willie Felge, the middle linebacker, has had an excellent first half. He leads the team with 100 tackles. He was an 189-pound wrestler in high school, and wrestlers make good football players because they understand leverage.
Well, you see the smile on his face because, again, K-State is going to have to punt, and this is three times that they've had to punt it away. Clock runs as we're about to go under 11 minutes left in his opening half. Again, the ball is not long, but this one is fielded and the tackle made immediately on Sutherland. But that one, he didn't let hit the turf and bounce, and as a result, it's only 37 yards.
And again, good coverage on this punt by Kansas State. And you know what the Kansas State coaches are all thinking about right now? Somebody has to turn the tide. Maybe somebody on defense, get a turnover, big play, big hit, offensively a big play, and then you're just one play away from getting back in this ball game.
Connolly got downfield to make the tackle on special teams. Well, look at his field position average. This is one of the worst for Purdue. They stretch it. Chapman tries to bounce it outside, and that's the longest gainer by the running back tonight. This Crabtree will take it out close to the 35-yard line.
When you look at this Purdue football team, it's a young offensive football team. They only have one senior starter, so next year ought to be a big year for this Purdue offensive unit.
But that entire offensive line, Mike, actually only one of the reserves. Wheel is a senior. Everybody else an underclassman. From a shotgun. Gets it away and right through the hands of Gabe Cox.
Travis Oakes, the middle linebacker, number 50, with pressure on Drew Brees. Didn't give him a chance to get this football.
Had to get it away very quickly. But again, it looked like a football that was catchable. Like it went right through his hands.
You know, the other thing, when you watch Purdue run offensive line wise, they do a lot of cut blocking at the line of scrimmage. The defensive linemen get chopped around their knees, and they don't like that. And by about the third or fourth quarter, you don't get much of a pass rush because guys are worrying about their knees for the beach.
They get a little frustrated. You're right. Brees steps up, buys some time, and just throws that one into the turf. It was very good coverage by Carter on Randall Lane.
And I want to go back to what you said. You know, one guy that could change this game around quick is Allen. And he's got to crowd again. He comes in with a bounce. I like those. I like his style.
Holding his hands up saying, cheer for me because I'm good. I lead the nation, and let me show you how.
I like his style.
Four punts in the first quarter. That's an Alamo Bowl record by Purdue. See if they come after him. They've been getting folks free in the middle, K-State. And the ball goes through his hands. Good heavens, what else can happen? Picked up by K-State and dropped. They battle for it at the one and recovered. Nope, still not recovered. At the one-foot line.
That may be the play that wakes up Kansas State.
Kansas State, the ball recovered by Lorzel.
High snap, went through right to the hands. And Kansas State bouncing the ball around, trying to, you always tell your player, just trying to scoop it in the end zone.
But it is K-State's football, and they are about 18 inches away.
Put an asterisk by that play because this game, whole game may change with this play.
An asterisk by that one. And that snap from center was an absolute rocket. And he just lost his concentration and it went out. Quarterback sneak. No signal. And there was a flag down on the near side as Fells is underneath that whole stack someplace.
And usually that's off sides where that was thrown. Let's see if we're... Yes. By alignment, off side. Right over the nose, right over the center.
I think Nugent, 82, yep, is the man who jumped in there. So now they moved it to about 9 inches away. Allen in the backfield along with Gouldsby. Going to throw the fade to the corner. Touchdown, McDonald. Well, the punting game has been close to disastrous for Purdue all night, and finally it crumbled on him and cost him the first score of the night.
It really did, and Darnell McDonald used his 6'3 frame on this fade route and caught the touchdown pass. He had 75 receptions during the year for 9 touchdowns. Had another one.
Martin Gramatica to attempt the extra point. And he got it. 9:49 left until halftime. So let's take a break. Our new score, Purdue 10, Kansas State 7. We'll be right back. Well, the K-State fans are now aroused, and they have good reason to be. They're on the scoreboard with an interesting call with first down and inches at the goal line, Mike.
Yeah, they go to split backs and throw the fade and get their 6'3 receiver on Henry Bell, 5'11 corner. Felt almost like feeling they'd take the easy way.
How about these numbers? In 20 minutes and 11 seconds of football, there have been 14 offensive possessions in this ballgame. That's a lot of start and stammers.
Yeah. Start and stops.
Start and stammer and stop. Clopton. He's free. Clopton is finally going to be tackled at the 49-yard line by Butler.
Yeah, the Butler did it, but Clopton setting up. Good field position for Drew Brees. Just hits this middle return, just gets some good blocks, got a little wiggle to him. Then Butler makes the tackle, but Purdue sets up shop in good field position.
Well, that's a great return. The interesting thing in watching that, to show you the kind of speed Butler has, he's still headed on cruise. He had not hit passing gear yet and still ran him down. But great field position for Drew Brees and Purdue. Quick pass, and it's that slip screen again, and Jones going to be stopped at around the 45-yard line.
Well, nice block by Randall Lane, the inside receiver. When you throw that bubble screen, your receiver's got to get on the outside right now and make a block. Watch number 84 right here with this good block that sets up Isaac Jones to break right behind him for good yards.
And, of course, the reason you can block downfield, as you know the rule in the colleges, as long as it's thrown behind the line of scrimmage, that is perfectly all right. That one hit at the line of scrimmage and tipped by Beisel. Monty Beisel tipped it at the line of scrimmage, and that's three times that we will not know if Drew Brees was on the money or not because the ball is knocked down. McIntosh has two.
Yeah, all defensive line coaches, Mo Lattimore, talked all week about get your hands up the line of scrimmage, even if you're getting blocked. And a lot of times, we talked about this, Purdue's offensive line blocks low. They'll go and block low, and so they're trying to bring the hands down of the defensive linemen.
9 of 23, 62 yards and a touchdown for Drew Brees. Third down, and they need to take it to the 40-and-a-half-yard line. Option play. Brees keeps it. Going to have the first down. McIntosh will finally make the tackle on him.
Well, the reason the running game, and there's a flag down, but the reason the running game's working so well is Kansas State's forced to take some of their linebackers out against these sets of Purdue's. And the draw play and the option play now have worked well for Drew Brees. I think too many men on the field for Kansas State.
Yep, sure was.
There's Jeff Kelly, and there's the linebacker. Three linebacker set, which Kansas State plays with all the time. They've only been able four times to have the three linebackers on the field. Two linebacker set, which is going to be the majority of the time. They've had 17 times. One linebacker set, that's nine times, which means two linebackers are standing over there. And they're not only losing their ability, Ron, they're inspirational leaders when they're on the field. So a problem for Kansas State tonight matching up.
Well, they're still substituting here, and they're going to have to get somebody off the field. Don't they have 12 out there?
Yeah, they got 12 again.
Yep, they do. And they're running at the last minute to Proctor, trying to get him off the field. This Purdue offense is beginning to do just what they wanted to do against K-State, and that is have them confused. Ball is hit. Was it a forward pass? An incomplete forward pass. Arm was going forward. It was Joe Bob Clements who hit him.
And, Ron, we've talked all year about walk-ons. Joe Bob Clements was a walk-on, came to Kansas State as a tight end, earned a scholarship before the 96 season.
We have an incomplete pass on the play. There's no flag on the play.
Joe Bob Clements had a big ball game in the Nebraska game, had nine tackles in the big win. Mike Stoops, defensive coordinator, talking to the field, trying to get lined up. Looks red hair is going to go to gray here tonight.
Here comes the blitz again. Got a man. Line because they gave him time to put up a touch pass.
You know, Isaac Jones has caught five touchdowns and make it six. He played quarterback in high school. He understands the passing game.
Dorsch with the extra point. And I think that is was a huge answer by Purdue to come right back after they had handed a gift off the special teams to K-State.
Yeah, they handed a gift, but remember their special teams play. They got out to the 50-yard line, but here's just a lob pass against Carter, the defensive back, Isaac Jones with the touchdown. But Ron, again, go back to the kickoff return that set Purdue in great field position. That was a little bit of an answer by Chris Clopton.
Game with just under 10 minutes remaining in the third quarter, with Purdue still leading Kansas State 17-7. The Boilermakers have the ball on their own 20-yard line, first down and 10 after a Wildcat punt.
Height of it. Real historical sight in this state, and the comment that's always made, I can't believe it's that small. K-State, that was the longest drive of the game, 38 yards, 5:02 off the clock, and no points. Here comes the safety blitz, and they throw the play that should work against it, and he couldn't get it back inside as Sutherland made the reception. And with that safety gone, Mike, they might have broken that one for a very long play.
Well, what the formation was three receivers close together, which called a bunch set, and then Vinny Sutherland came in motion. Drew Brees just raised up through the quick screen. You see all the receivers so close together, and now they all become blockers. Sutherland catches the football. Good blocks downfield. Gabe Cox with a good block.
If he could have cut the thing back inside, it had a chance of adding some real big yardage. Brees, they want to throw back on the screen, and they do. And Crabtree, there's nothing. Seminole, what a nice defensive play as he stays at home and tackles them for a big loss.
Made a big play out of Smith Center, Kansas, the linebacker that's led this team in tackles all year. Was the only member of the Kansas State defense back there in good shape.
Stratton checks into the lineup, number 89. And at Stratton, for the most part, they don't use him just to block. He is their best pass catching end, number 89, a redshirt freshman out of Oak Brook, Illinois. It's Isaac Jones in motion, bottom of the screen. Brees, quarterback draw, nothing doing.
Better job there by the defensive line. Andre Rowe and Joe Bob Clements, they had a little game going on the defensive line. And that stopped the quarterback draw, Drew Brees.
To 17-7 if you just joined us. Clock running at 8 minutes and 35 seconds to play. Third quarter. Purdue, a 2-touchdown and in some quarters more underdog in this ballgame, up by 10. Brees, long throw, got it complete, and Daniels will pick up the first down and come out of bounds at the 34. Cooper was there to make the play on him.
Cooper shows you his speed from that strong safety position, making that play. Brent Venerable's the linebacker coach, on his way to Oklahoma after this game, having a conversation with his outstanding strong safety.
So Danny Rogers prepares to kick it away. David Miller, the nation's leading punt returner, or David Allen, I should say, standing and waiting for the return. High pass over his head. Second one we've had tonight, and K-State had the return on it, and he missed it. And K-State will recover it for a touchdown.
The ball goes over your head to scoop it out of the end zone, take the safety. That's what he tried to do, but he overran it. You do not want to give this ball.
For Sandifer, that is the second one.
Joe Tiller timing the punter, but the snap goes over his head, and everything breaks down.
Abbott winds up. That extra point is no good. Gramatica yanks it, and it goes wide left. First one that he has missed all year, and consider this as we go to break. The only two touchdowns K-State has in this ball game are from errant snaps from center. We'll be right back. Ron Franklin, Mike Godfrey, and Adrian Karsten coming to you from a very noisy Alamo Dome in San Antonio.
This is a good move right here by Joe Tiller to rest Rosevelt Colvin. A lot of times you'll bring your backup defensive lineman in when you've got the other team down the field inside the 20-25-yard line. Give him a little bit of a rest.
This is the worst starting position by K-State tonight. Here's where you got to be really careful of Michael Bishop, and you can't get lazy on any step. They'll go with the running game, and it's going to be Allen, who is tackled by Fells close to the five.
Michael Bishop took a long time at the line of scrimmage there. What he's doing right now, Ronnie, is he's looking. He's going up to the line of scrimmage with a formation. He's looking to the sideline for Bill Snyder if he wants to change the play. It's given more of an opportunity to call the play based on what they're in defensively.
Well, David Allen is out. Only the fullback Goolsby is there. And Paredes, number 87, comes in at wide receiver. Ball is fumbled. It's in the end zone. Touchdown, David Nugent. David Nugent with the touchdown.
Never got to football.
David Nugent, a junior from Collierville, Tennessee, just outside of Memphis, makes the recovery. And Mike Godfrey's right. Brian Goolsby, who doesn't carry that often, just never got connection from Bishop. Good, and with 52 seconds left in the third quarter, our new score, Purdue 24 and Kansas State 13.
Watch the handoff. Michael Bishop almost like flipped it into the hands of Brian Goolsby, and they just never had it.
Mike, he also was looking at Wakori. I mean, Wakori was almost there to take the handoff for him.
Yeah, number 49, Chuki Wakori, was right in the backfield. And you could see the frustration of Bill Snyder on the sideline.
Bill's only given away one tonight. He's got one more to give because Purdue's given two away. So Nugent makes the recovery, and of course that's the dream of any lineman, to recover for a touchdown. And David scores for Purdue and puts his team back up now by 11 points with that miss of the extra point by Gramatica. There's a good look at David. Collierville, just to the south of Memphis, Tennessee, wound up heading to West Lafayette, Indiana, to play his college football. And right now is extremely proud. Here comes Button's kickoff. Murphy, 2 yards deep, he'll return it. Remember I told you this is the 4-2 sprinter. And he ran right into the man. That's Bell, who is there to make the tackle.
Following the Purdue touchdown, a Michael Bishop interception set up a Travis Doerr's 26-yard field goal, which put the Boilermakers up by 14 with 4 seconds remaining in the third quarter. However, early in the fourth quarter, the Wildcats moved the ball down the field. And as we rejoin the action with just over 12 minutes remaining in the game, Kansas State has the ball on the Purdue 8-yard line, facing third down and 3 in the 1998 Alamo Bowl, right here on ESPN Classic.
We are back. You see the clock, 12:08 remaining in the ball game, and it's third down Kansas State. And they need to take it to the 5.5-yard line to move the sticks. Bishop in the option play gets a block at the five and able to have the first down as David Allen gets belted out of bounds by John Reeves.
The speed option to Michael Bishop takes it right to the defensive end, kicks it out. But Brian Goolsby again with another nice block that sets up this first down. Watch number 30 come out of the backfield and make this block for David Allen.
The play clears for the Kansas State.
Henry Bell.
First and goal,
12 for 80 yards for David Allen tonight. First and goal, Wildcats. Allen again, right side, touchdown, K-State. Brian Handley with a huge block. And that is the first offensive touchdown in this ball game that K-State has taken the offense and driven it down the field. Taking it over at the 6-inch line or recovering a fumble in the end zone by the defense or special teams. Gramatica to attempt the extra point. Missed his first of the year on that last touchdown. It's a good pass and knocks this one home. So there's a timeout. 11:59 left in our ball game. It's a 7-point Purdue lead. To 20, Purdue leading Kansas State, just under 10 minutes to play. And Drew Brees is in the Alamo Bowl record book for the number of attempts tonight. He's 19 of 44, but he's thrown three interceptions, 168 yards, and two touchdowns. Crabtree takes it for short yardage into the middle. That's Chris Johnson, who's down at the bottom of the pile, along with Jeff Kelly.
And one of the reasons he's in that record book is because their inability to run the football. The only chance they got of moving the football is Drew Brees throwing it. And, Ron, you talk about changing times. I was reading where Bob Greasy in his three-year career threw 28 touchdown passes at Purdue, and Drew has had 36 touchdown passes in the regular season. So you talk about changing times in the Big Ten and at Purdue.
Here comes the blitz in the middle, and they give it to Crabtree, and he breaks it. Crabtree will have the first down, and he's still going across midfield. Carter finally stopped a 16-yard gain.
Well, Jake Crabtree probably knows a lot of these Kansas State players because he played at Coffeyville Junior College in Kansas, where he rushed for 24 touchdowns last year. Purdue with success recruiting the junior colleges.
First down, they put the ball at the 47. They keep it on the ground again. Crabtree has five, has 10. Counted off at around 15 yards. Carter will make the tackle. And Coach Stoops, well, again, rocking and reeling in that chair upstairs because he knows that as tough as the offensive output has been tonight, only one touchdown, but the offense really, that if they go down by 14 again, it's going to be a big mountain to climb, Mike.
Yeah, and their offense just isn't playing that well. But when you go to a one-back set, spread people all out over the football field, your run support sometimes can get mistakes. And that's what's happening to Kansas State.
They go with the third running play in a row. This could be a Purdue record.
Going back to the days of Bob Greasy now. Bob was handing off.
Seminole makes the tackle. You know, it was interesting in asking Joe, I said, the nicest flattery that you can have is when somebody starts doing what you're doing. How much around the Big Ten have you seen some of your offense beginning to spring up? And he said, here and there. He's entered to see more one-back and no-back stuff, particularly one-back.
Coaches steal a lot of things off that tape.
Crabtree, 9 carries, 44 yards now. They fake it to him. Brees gets his pass away, complete. And they will give him forward progress enough for the first down to Isaac Jones. Adrian Karsten, what do you got for us?
Ron, this offense we're watching by Purdue tonight is certainly not Big Ten style offense. You know, 45 attempted passes, 46. This is something that Coach Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, says, you know, you don't have to have big studs across the front. We've been with this 12 years and we're still learning. It's an offense born in a high school back in Thousand Oaks, California, for crying out loud. You don't need the big studs. We can finesse a little bit. Sometimes two backs, sometimes no backs. They're going to stick with it and keep learning, Ron, and keep being successful.
Yep, you're right. It's Sherman Oaks, I believe, Adrian, is where that high school started using it with the no backs. But the Oaks was right. Just wasn't a thousand.
Well, you talk about what Adrian is talking about in both these tackles, Matt Light. Jim Coletto signed him as a tight end, so they moved him to tackle. And Brandon Gore, the other tackle, played basketball at Muncie Southside in a nationally ranked high school team. So it gives you an idea that their tackles are very athletic to handle speed rushes off the outside.
Second down. Brees sets nicely, gets it complete, and stepping out of bounds is Randall Lane. 6:52 left in the ball game. Carter and Proctor were out there on the cover.
This whole Kansas State defensive team is going to have nightmares of this Purdue offense. All the formations, all the throws.
Well, Bill Snyder said in our meeting, I said, what do they finally do to you? And he said, they just out formation you to death.
Frustrate you.
Brees, well, had a receiver running a zig and someone else zagged, and Cooper was the closest man to it. I think Cox was the man that he wanted, and Cox ran like a toward the post. He should have stayed outside.
I think Drew Brees misread that pass.
Travis Dortch to attempt the field goal, and this one's going to come from 37 yards away from the near hash mark. Travis, a freshman out of Bozeman, Montana, 6'6", 192 pounds, has one from 25 and 26 tonight. Good pass, and this one is right down the Alamo. So the Purdue Boilermakers, with that field goal, push their lead back to 10 points. And we'll take a break with 6:44 remaining. The Big Ten right now up by 10. Well, we're back. 6:44 remaining, 30-20. Purdue on top. Purdue is a huge underdog in this ball game. And there's the man, Frank Murphy. And he wants the football, and he can get it. Let's see if it's returnable. Yep, it is. It's in the field of play from the four. Tackled inside the 15 by Stelma. First down from the 13-yard line. Bishop, deep retreat, pumps it. Going long, got a man open. And McDonald makes the catch. Flag goes down, but he will score it easily from 87 yards. Let's call it 88 yards.
Billy Gustin tried to run into him to get the pass interference, but Darnell McDonald with good concentration brought that pass in for the score. And just like that, Kansas State back in his ballgame.
Pass interference on the defense. By rule, we have a touchdown. Penalty is applied.
What good concentration by McDonald, Ron, as he made that catch. 1,092 receiving yards this season.
Well, Gramatica to attempt the extra point and try to make it a three-point ball game again with 6:23 remaining. And he does.
Busting coverage by Purdue in the secondary because Darnell McDonald is going to come down the field and there's nobody going to pick him up. Billy Gustin just tries to run him down knowing that the ball's coming to him. Gets the interference call, but McDonald, with good concentration, watches eyes, just watches the football, brings it in, and then takes it in for the touchdown. Good arm strength by Michael Bishop. Threw it a long way.
And Gustin disgusted with himself. It's one of those things where with the college rule, heck, if he had known, just go ahead and tackle him.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether he was supposed to be over the top or someone, the corner, sat down on the play. Henry Bell, it may have been Henry Bell supposed to continue with the wide receiver, Darnell McDonald.
They're now saying officially 88 yards, and that is an Alamo Bowl record by McDonald to pull his team to within three. Clopton 2 yards deep, and he'll go down on one knee.
Ron, two things. Purdue, first of all, has played a very good football game. They get a young team. This is a team they're going to have to be reckoned with next year in the Big Ten. Drew Brees will be a candidate for a lot of awards next year. Kansas State, I still think, and I'm still saying, they're the victim, you know, of not being picked up in this bowl alliance. Last loss.
BCS, Mike.
BCS, and I think it's hurt them tonight in this ball game. They're trying to get back in this thing.
Crabtree is going to be stopped for about a yard loss. Carter came over from his cornerback position, one of the first men there. Right now, what Joe Tiller wants to see happen is let that clock move, but they're going to have to move the chain several times to get it down where they want it.
Yeah, without a doubt now, Purdue needs a couple first downs. 5:48 left to go in this ball game.
Play again. Crabtree takes a real shot from McGraw. You could see John come up quickly. Cooper was there as well. And now decision time, third down, and from where they're marking it, it's still going to be about 9 yards for the first.
Ronan, as you look at this play, Purdue will try to find a matchup where they like it the best, and they tried to have tried unsuccessfully to go against Cooper tonight, number 40.
They're 2 of 15 on third down conversions, and they missed their last 8. Cox makes the catch, and also Jones, I beg your pardon, and Cooper is right there to make the hit on him. They're not booing, it's Cooper.
But what happened on that play is they man coverage, and Jarrod Cooper ran across with Gabe Cox, and he read the screen. Watch number 40, Jarrod Cooper, as he goes across. Now he reads the screen. Now he breaks up and makes the tackle and forces this punt. Nice, nice play by Cooper.
Daniels again, the man to snap. Low pass from center, gets his kick away, and a spiral's not going to turn over. Allen from the 42. That's the reason he leads the nation in kick return. Danny Rogers, the punter, made the tackle.
And that's been the player of the game for Kansas State on offense. He has brought some excitement with him tonight.
35 yards in the kick and 32 on the return.
He just bursts here. I mean, he just shows you his speed, flat out cutting ability and working up the football field.
play. And K-State can smell momentum going in their direction. Here comes the quarterback draw. Still on his feet. And Bishop will take it close to the first down. Around the 16-yard line. Lorzell makes the tackle on him.
Well, Michael Bishop's not used to losing, Ron. He, in his junior college career, in his college career at Kansas State, 46-2. Pretty good odds for your quarterback.
Purdue. But that lead is very much in jeopardy right here. They did move the chains. It is first down from the Boilermaker 16. Hickson breaks by a tackle, breaks by a second one as they try to take the ball away at the 11. Nugent is down there to make the tackle. You thought that he was going to be dropped at the line of scrimmage. He gains 5.
Well, John Reeves got in the backfield along with another player for Purdue, but they just couldn't bring him down. As they're playing for the hardware now.
Joe Tiller trying to get his defense sparked. Bishop, quarterback draw again. And Gustin neckties him just shy of the 5-yard line.
Playing with a little more emotion now in this quarter. Michael Bishop, he's like turned it up a notch. These last two quarterback draws, he's running with more authority. You see a nice block by Ryan Young. Now all of a sudden the rush of Purdue is a non-factor because everything's going up inside.
And when you look at the difference, 309, the average size of the K-State line to 268 for that defensive front for Purdue. When it comes to a muscle situation such as this, that it's a decided advantage to the Wildcats.
Yeah, and you chase Michael Bishop the entire ball game. You've had that long layoff. You tire out a little bit. Bishop on the sideline right now getting the play.
Plenty of time in the play clock. It is a 13, now a 12, now 11. Bishop straight ahead with the quarterback sneak, and they will have the first down just inside the 5. Willie Fells, the junior out of Palatka, Florida, who has had a really outstanding game for Purdue, makes the tackle.
Here's Ron. We're in the huddle. Michael Bishop challenges that offensive line. This is heavy senior football team on the offense. 4 seniors on that offensive line.
Now a timeout as the entire Purdue defense is walking toward the sideline, and it is the Boilermakers who call the timeout. We'll take it with them. 2:08 left in the ballgame. Boilermakers by 3. Names have been engraved on there as yet. And folks wearing purple are thinking that they're going to yank victory from that gentleman you were just looking at. Purdue has been shockingly on top and in command of this football game until about the last 6 or 7 minutes.
And you've seen a different Michael Bishop in that last period of time.
Purdue led 27-13 with 4 seconds left in the third quarter. Hickson is tackled by O'Keefer.
And it's a credit to Bill Snyder and his coaching staff. We talked about the lack of concentration. We expected him not to be at emotional level in this ballgame, yet here they are with 1:45 left, a chance to win this football game or to take the lead.
Second and goal. Hickson met in the backfield as they got penetration, and Willie Fells again. Bishop quickly gets away from the offense, runs to the sideline to get the play rather than take a signal. And a timeout has been called again by Purdue's defense with 1:27 left. We'll take it with him. Right back. So here they come to the line of scrimmage. It is third down for the Wildcats. Throws for the end zone. Touchdown, Swift.
The touchdown is good on the play. After the play is over, we got a dead ball, personal foul on the defense.
Wow.
After this is on the PAT.
What a nice call by Mark Mangino and Ron Hudson, and just a beautiful call to Justin Swift.
Martin Gramatica with the extra point attempt. Well, he got it, and it is now, flag is down. Let's wait and check that. Offsides, Purdue.
He'll turn it down.
Mm-hmm. Now a field goal won't help you. Gotta score a touchdown.
Offside on the defense. Penalty is refused. PAT is good.
34-30, K-State.
Here's the touchdown. Michael Bishop with a good fake, and they were thinking option. And then raise up and throw the football to tight end Justin Swift. O'Keefer was in coverage, but just couldn't stay with Justin Swift. And Ron, kind of a bittersweet game for Bill Snyder again. He talked about being here, and he's losing two of his coaches, may lose a third coach, and Fabris, the linebacker coach, to South Carolina.
South Carolina, yeah.
And Mark Mangino has an offer. He can't afford to lose Mark Mangino because he runs and heads up the whole recruiting for him. So Bill Snyder, after this ball game, has got to piece some coaches together, and cannot afford to lose this man right here. Tough enough losing the three coaches that he's going to lose.
But Drew Brees on the sideline looking up at the clock. Got a minute, 24 seconds to work with. Let's see if Gramatica kicks this one. Yep. Into the base of the end zone. They'll not return it.
Go back to all the missed opportunities Purdue's had in this ball game. The drop passes.
Cox deep over the middle.
Yeah.
And also, you know, Bell on that interception when he dropped it in the wide open field. But they still have 1:24 left. Is low. That's the 49th pass attempt by Drew Brees looking for Jones. A lot of people still asking the question, how did Drew Brees come out of Austin, Westlake High School, and nobody in Texas or the Big 12 recruit him? As a starter, never lost a football game in high school. But he did have a serious knee injury. I've heard a lot of reasons why he was not taken. But he's still got two more years at Purdue.
He's going to do a lot of winning for the Boilermakers.
Steps up, gets it away, and that one is too low. The most difficult thing for them next year, he could be not only as good but better, but they lose Iowa and Illinois on their schedule, and they pick up Ohio State and Michigan, and both of those games are on the road. That is not a good swap.
No, but they return most of their football team, and they've nationally recruited more since Joe Tiller's been there. They only have four starters from the state of Indiana. So they're all over the country, which goes from his Wyoming days.
Two of 16 third down conversions, and they have missed their last nine. Brees' pass got it complete, and they'll have the first down
A good effort by Chris Daniels.
Mm-hmm. 1:07 showing on the clock. Now it's whistled back in. 1:04. Now 1:03. Gets this one complete. That's Randall Lane.
Sometimes they have trouble with the easier catches, but Randall Lane just snatches one out of the sky for Drew Brees.
Brees. Oh, my goodness, just beyond Chris Daniels, and a flag.
Chapman number one, because he kind of grabbed out. It looked like to slow the receiver down. Chris Daniels, the intended receiver. Lamar Chapman has played well tonight.
We have pass interference on the defense. That's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
As we said, Chris Daniels, receiver, and not much contact, but enough to get that flag.
Penalty yards, well, they have been considerable. Brees gonna run it, and he's got a lot of running room. Gonna take it as far as he can, and he did get out of bounds. Very wisely got what he could with diving out of bounds. Chapman was there, but he is down around the 25, and that's enough for the first down.
Here's where Drew Brees is really good at, because he can feel the rush. Jarrod Cooper, number 40, is gonna come from the top of the screen. He feels the pressure, ducks up underneath, and picks up the first down, and then tries to get out of bounds. Lamar Chapman on the hit.
You can see his wide receiver wisely coming off rather than throwing a block and being called for a clip. Brees lobs it for the end zone. Got him there. Touchdown, Isaac Joe.
Throw the ball any better than that. Drew Brees stuck it right in there to Isaac Jones. What a drive for the Purdue Boilermakers.
Extra point is good. A three-point game with 30 seconds left. And I mean the K-State bench and their side of the field is sitting in stunned silence. They cannot believe that Drew Brees took that football and went down the field on their defense.
That's as good as a pro drive on Sunday for John Elway, Denver comeback. Drew Brees just finds Isaac Jones open. He adjusts to the football, makes that touchdown catch, and puts the Boilermakers ahead. The senior starter on the offense, Isaac Jones.
And I think there were probably 10 groans in the Big Ten Conference. That's the other 10 coaches that know this guy's going to be around for two more years and they got to face it.
Well, that's a great drive. If they can end this season with the win, as I said before, this is a young football team that will contend for the Big Ten Championship next year.
Now here's the next dilemma. You're not out of the woods yet. You can't kick away to K-State, because Murphy has already proven that he can take it the distance. You know, do you line drive?
Yeah,
what do you do, Mike?
Line drive it right here, and get good coverage, because still a field goal with 30 seconds would tie this thing.
Well, Gramatica's kick is longest to 65 yards. So that means you got to get it around the 48-yard line of Purdue, and you still got an opportunity. You see his numbers, and he is relacing that shoe. And there's the kick on the ground, and it's bobbled for a moment. Now Murphy trying to find some place to run, and he is going to be hemmed in at the 11-yard line. And the bad thing about it is he wasted about 8 seconds off the clock.
Well, nice job there on the kick. A little knuckleball.
Willie Fells playing special teams as well. For all the wonderful things that happened offensively on the drive, defensively, Fells, Rosevelt, Colvin, O'Keefer, Wakori.
Can't forget Gus. Nugent, two interceptions.
Nugent scored a touchdown. Destin had two interceptions in the ballgame. This defense.
Reeves has played very well at the linebacker spot.
Yep. Brees doesn't want to look on the sideline.
This would be big for him to come back home.
Oh. Bishop back in the end zone, rolling it. Flag has come down way behind the play, and that runs the clock down to 16 seconds.
It's got to be a hold.
Way back at the 5-yard line, this marker was thrown. You can see Colvin pointing, say, yeah, let's take it back. So does O'Keefer.
I believe they're holding O'Keefer.
I think Colvin is as good a defensive end as we've seen the entire year. What do you think?
He's a good player. Here's the hold right here. A tackle on O'Keefer. And that'll take him all the way back to the Alamo here. Thomas Barnett, the freshman walk-on. Can't lose too much yardage from the five, but you lose a little.
Colvin, the defensive player of the game, 8 tackles, 3 sacks for 25 yards.
And Ron, before we get off this thing, this Alamo Bowl has been a great sight this whole week with these fans here. It's been very colorful.
Mike, our crew's had this game 3 times and been here for the final 4 last year and saw the regionals the year prior to that. This city does a great job for sports events.
Excellent.
Bishop rolls the pocket. Throws as he is hit, and this one's just up in the air for grabs. And it is tipped, and it is not intercepted. 7 seconds showing on the clock. Both Ben Smith and Adrian Beasley were there. Don't forget, SportsCenter is coming up next. Right now, it's going to take a miracle for K-State to pull this thing out. And, Mike, the only thing I can liken this situation for K-State to is Arkansas, who had the opportunity up at Tennessee to come away with the biggest upset of the year. They lost that football game, and then the next week they lost again. It's like they couldn't retrieve it. And K-State, much a similar situation as far as they thought they had it regrouped, and they're going to wind up losing to this young Purdue football team, it would appear right now.
Takes a lot out of you, Ron. You lose that goal, and plus add to it Purdue, a team that just frustrates you along with the ball game that they lost. Drew Brees has had an outstanding ball game. Joe Tiller, his staff, congratulations to them. To Bill Snyder, I don't know of any coaching staff that's done as good a job in the last 10 years.
Well, here's that schedule we were talking about for Purdue. They keep Notre Dame. They got Central Florida, Central Michigan, Northwestern, at Michigan, at Ohio State, and back-to-back weekends. Those are the 2 games they pick up, losing Iowa and Illinois. Then they get Michigan State, Penn State at home, and you can see the at Minnesota, the Wisconsin, then open and close it out with Indiana. Larzell on the sideline, all the Purdue players asking their backers to stand up and to lend support. The secondary has dropped off 38 and 40 yards downfield just to make sure that no home run ball is thrown on them on what should be the final play of this ball game. Bishop runs up into the pocket. 2 seconds down to one, gets his pass away, and it is going to be intercepted. John Reeves with the interception is knocked out of bounds, and this one is over. And Joe Tiller gets a cool bath, and this is an excited Purdue football team.
Again, Ron, you got to credit Purdue. They came to play, and they played, and they made that drive that won the football game. And hats off to both these coaching staffs. They've had great years.
So Drew Brees to Isaac Jones, and that was the difference maker as Purdue, a big underdog by over two touchdowns in this ball game, comes up with the upset, 37 to 34.